grandfather inherited a huge library from an uncle. So we had, every room was just books from start to, I never learned how to use a library until I went to college, because they were all right there, you know, all of them. And yes, we were encouraged and we read all the time. Of course, there wasn't any television then, so my brother and I would read. Dickens was part of, member of the family, practically.
Carolyn Cassidy was an American writer who first entered the mind of America when she was made into a character in Jack Kerouac's novel, On the Road. Jack Kerouac, along with Neal Cassidy, Allen Ginsberg, and William S. Burroughs, were a group of novelists and poets who arose in U.S. literature after World War II. These poets and novelists became known as the Beat Generation. Their writings were inspired by drugs, sexual freedom, and their view on American society in the 1950s. These men sought to go against the grain and challenge the societal norms and pressures of conventional family life. In Kerouac's novel, On the Road, he documents his cross-country road trips with his fellow beat writers, where he and his friends are described using aliases. Carolyn was the inspiration for Kerouac's character, Camille, in the novel.
Carolyn Cassidy was born Carolyn Elizabeth Robertson in Lansing, Michigan on April 23, 1923. Her mother was a formalist English professor and her father a biochemist. She was raised in a strict environment which revolved mainly around literature. At 8 years old, Carolyn and her family moved to Nashville where she attended an elite prep school. She attended Bennington College in Vermont before relocating again to Colorado. In March 1947, she was studying painting and design at the University of Denver when she was introduced to Neal Cassidy. Through her marriage to Neal, she will forever be associated with the Beat Generation.
Being a woman in society was not easy during the 1950s and 60s, especially if you were also a mother. Many women were not expected to get an education and were groomed by their parents to become obedient housewives. Carolyn was lucky in the sense that her parents so highly valued education and literature. The struggle for Carolyn, like other Beat Generation women, was that men weren't the only ones who wanted to experience sexual experimentation, drugs, and mind-expanding road trips. However, unlike male Beats, women were much more restricted by their social expectations. While Jack, Neal, and Allen were out on the road, Carolyn had to take care of the house and children.
In 1990, Carolyn published her autobiography, Off the Road, a straightforward account of events in Kerouac's On the Road. Off the Road also sheds light on the domestic hardships faced by women in the 1960s America. As Neal's wife and Kerouac's sporadic lover, Carolyn Cassidy was perfectly situated to document the birth of the Beat Generation and its influence on American literature.
One of the most interesting points to most readers of Off the Road was the romantic relationship between Carolyn and Jack Kerouac that began in the spring of 1952. Kerouac was living with the Cassidys and their three children in a small house in San Francisco. Carolyn and Jack's fling was totally accepted and was even encouraged by Neal Cassidy, who had himself often been involved with other women during his travels on the road with Jack. Carolyn describes that after the start of her relationship with Jack, she, for the first time, felt involved and more highly esteemed on an intellectual level with these men.
Her personal accounts provide our generation with a better idea of the roles of women in that time. Love triangle aside, Carolyn didn't quite understand everyone's fascination with the adventures of the Beats. Though Carolyn didn't understand the excitement, the Beats' stories and influence still have a place in the hearts of many in every generation since their debut. Her brave account sets the record straight and fills the gaps for the Beat enthusiasts. She shined much-needed light on the struggles of women in the 1950s and established herself as much more than just a muse to the men who pioneered an era in American literature.